beautiful weather out here today for some Buckeye baseball. It is their first official practice of the 2018 season. Now, we just caught up with head coach Greg Beals, who said he's really excited about this team. They've put in a lot of work preseason, and he said everyone who signs up to represent this university knows that they are signing up for high expectations.
But Purdue was able to come out on top 25-22. Anna, what did you like out of that Purdue offense and defense?
Purdue came in tonight ready for a win. They were hungry to grab that in just three sets. That showed, especially in sets one and two, with their strong attack at the net and fluid motion on defense. Everything seemed natural on Purdue's side. And for Ohio State, it just did not seem to click. Coach, last night you were blanked and then completely different offensive performance tonight from your team. What can you attribute those changes to?
Well, I think we talked about our toughness and our competitiveness. And, you know, last night you got to give their pitcher a lot of credit. Stever threw a really good ball game. He commanded the ball really well against us. And sometimes good pitching beats good hitting. That was the case last night. Today, our guys came out with a little fight and knew we needed to get a ball game and get a win today. And we got a couple quality hits, and we got a big hit from McGowan there late in the ball game.
That was a big hit from McGowan, and he's been very effective for you all season. Talk to me about what he adds to this team.
Well, he adds dynamic. You know, he's got the ability to hit. He's hitting 400, but he's also got the ability to hit the ball out of the ballpark and create instant offense for us. And, you know, I give Noah a lot of credit. He's worked really hard. He struggled last year, and we made some adjustments in the offseason to his swing and cleaned it up, and he's having a great year. And he's just a staple in the middle of our lineup.
Now, what's the mentality moving into tomorrow, trying to win this series?
That's it right there. We got to find every way we can, like we did today, find a way to win a ball game tomorrow, win a series.
The battle for the starting quarterback position continues here in Columbus. Joe Burrow, Tate Martell, and Dwayne Haskins are all working to fill JT Barrett's role from last season. Now, Coach Meyer said he's unsure as to whether Ohio State will have a leader at quarterback by the end of the spring, but he did say the void of Barrett's departure is beginning to feel less evident. After the first half alone, you already had a double-double, which is your second double-double already this season. Do you feel your transition to the starting five this season has impacted your performance?
Yeah, I think it has. But most importantly, I'm just trying to be whatever my team needs me to be. Before the game, Coach just talked about rebounding and that it was going to be key for our win. So I just tried to lock in on that and get as many rebounds as I could.
You mentioned rebounds being key to your game, and tonight you had 18 rebounds, which is your career high. At just 5'8", how do you find so much success at the boards? Ohio State wrapped up their regular season with a victory over Michigan, marking the first time in series history that a team has come back from a 14 or more point deficit. Ohio State followed that up with a victory over Wisconsin to win the Big Ten championship, and now they will face USC in the Cotton Bowl on December 29th. It is a cold one today at Bill Davis Stadium, but in just three short months, the Buckeyes will take the field to host their 2018 home opener on Friday, March 16th against California State University Northridge. Now, the Buckeyes struggled to find their groove in their 2017 season, but some new additions to the 2018 roster are sure to spark some change. Stephanie, you grabbed your 13th double-double of the season tonight up against one of the top defensive teams in the Big Ten. How did you make it work in the paint?
Man, I have no idea. As you can see, I had a really tough time the first half. But that wasn't important to me. What wasn't important to me was scoring. You know, I had to do whatever it was that I could do at the time, and that was rebounding.
You are currently leading the nation in three-pointers. You had four tonight. How important is that three ball to your game?
Seeing that it's the more teams I play, the smarter teams I play, the harder it is to get in inside, make layups, draw and pitch. So the three is not important to me, but I mean, it's the only shot I could take in some moments. I could also be effective driving and pitching a teammate. So whenever we can get that perimeter shot going, it's always a good thing.
With still 3 weeks remaining of the regular season, Kelsey Mitchell has broken yet another record. During Saturday's defeat over Wisconsin, Mitchell hit a three-pointer in her 81st consecutive game, which is the NCAA record. It has been a season full of honor and recognition for the senior guard, but what does it all mean to Kelsey? She was able to describe the feeling in just one word, normal. Noah, game-winning hit tonight also happened to be a home run. Can't get much better than that. Talk to me about that feeling.
Oh, yeah, it feels good. I mean, I was down the count and just looking for a pitch to put in play and hit it hard somewhere.
Kind of slow at the beginning of the game, and then Ohio State pulled away, Hannah. What happened?
Yeah, William and Mary hung with Ohio State at the start of the first, but towards the end of the first and all through the second half, Ohio State really took control of the game, coming away with a 35-point win this afternoon. Now, two Buckeyes put up their career highs today, Kata Bates-Diop with 27 points and Andrew Dockage with 8 points.
but Ohio State was truly able to come away.
There was a lot of back and forth there in the first set due to errors on both sides. Service errors, attack errors, and errors on defense. But Ohio State was really able to figure it out and pull away in the second and third set. Coach, you are now 6-0 all-time against Rutgers. How important was it for you to grab the win tonight?
Well, we beat a really good team. They're very talented. They play really hard, and they just came off a big win versus Michigan. So really good win for our team tonight.
Now, Michaela Waterman's still recovering. How did your team adjust to her absence tonight?
You know, I thought Alexa Hart gave us a lot of good minutes, and she's been playing well. She played more of those minutes tonight. I also thought Jensen Coretti was really good off the bench.
Quick turnaround heading to Florida this weekend. What's the focus for the final stretch of games in the regular season?
Yeah, we got a lot of tough games starting with Sunday. South Florida's a great team, and that's going to be a real challenge for us. But we got to have two great practices before we go on the road.
Thank you. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Stephanie Mavunga's versatility makes her the ultimate threat in the post. The 6'3" redshirt senior is currently the only active player in the country with over 1,000 career points, 1,000 career rebounds, and 250 career blocks. Now, in the first half tonight, Mavunga leads the Buckeyes in rebounds with 7, but there's more to come in the second half from this powerhouse post. Redshirt senior Lene Harper has been a burst of energy for the Buckeyes. Now, last year, Harper was named Big Ten Sixth Player of the Year, but this season, she has earned herself a starting spot. Coach, your full court press and your trap defense was very effective tonight. Your team had 11 steals. Is that pressure defense something you emphasize strongly at practice?
Yeah, you know, we're coming off a 9-day break in between games, and we've been working on that, so it was great to see that work tonight. And, you know, overall, it's a good win for us. I thought we shared the ball. We looked a little ragged early on, like a team that's been off for 9 days. But overall, good win for us against a good Dartmouth team.
It was a good win, and it was a team effort, as it usually is with your team. When you have so many key players on one team, how do you help each member find their role?
Well, I think the biggest thing is for us to just share the ball and make the extra pass. And when we did that tonight, we got great shots. And when we get good shots, we're a good enough offensive team that we're going to have success. And I thought, especially in the second half, I was really pleased with the way we moved the ball.
Now, Ohio State did face defeat on Sunday against Louisville in a 95-90 overtime battle. But Kelsey Mitchell said the team has a lot of the season left to make changes, and they're focused on turning the page.